Grill, welcome back to South Africa, and this is South African Prepper. One thing I've been thinking a lot about is a bit about the South African history, and especially our people, the Boer Nation. And the one thing that always stands out is that they've always wanted freedom. So I'm not going to go back into the history now because this is not a history lesson, but they've always strived for some kind of freedom. And I thought to myself, how can one actually obtain freedom? And I've been thinking about this for a long time now. And I've come to realize that freedom can only exist if you are actually courageous and if you have courage. And courage can only come from when you take risks. And you can only take risks when you try and create opportunities for yourself. So it's almost like a pyramid where you start at the bottom, you create an opportunity for yourself, which causes you to take risks, which causes you to be courageous, which then causes you to have freedom. And this can pertain to your normal life. It can pertain to your finances, and it can pertain to community life or civil society life. I've also come to realize that some of the biggest gamblers in the world are farmers. A farmer will go borrow money to buy a piece of land, and then he'll go borrow more money to buy a tractor and implements. And then he'll go borrow more money to go buy seeds and fertilizers, all to plant in the ground. And then hopefully it'll come up and he'll have a big harvest then to pay for all of this borrowed money. So I do think that farmers have got big balls. Doesn't matter where farmers are in the world, big balls. To take such big risks and such big gambling decisions in their life. But that is why farmers are courageous. And that is why you see the protest in Europe of farmers closing down big cities, spraying poop all over Parliament. Farmers are indeed courageous. And I think we have, as society, been lied to because the way that society is structured has got nothing to do with taking risks and being courageous. Think about it for a second. You go to school, you finish school, then you go to college or university, and you are taught how to do your specific job. If it's an accountant or doctor or a dentist or engineer, look, we do need all of those people. But you are taught how to specifically do your job. There's no risk involved in doing your job. So you never become courageous. You never take risks. You don't create opportunities because you are taught how to do a specific job, which means in turn that you never experience freedom. And here's the crux about freedom is freedom is actually the ultimate top point of being happy. To be free is to be happy. And I think that's why society today, the people are so unhappy because they are not free. And there are many ways to be free. You can be financially free. You can be free in your heart and your soul. You can be free in your job. Doesn't matter what job you do. Like I said, we need the people that go and study. We need the doctors and the engineers and the dentists and the tradesmen, the people that go and learn. We do need them. But are you free? And then there's a freedom of being free from governments, and that's a total different discussion because we've gotten to a point where I don't think there's a country in the world that are free from government. And it's been proven in 2020 when we all got locked down and told you need to listen to us. You cannot buy flip-flops and toilet paper is out of stock. Remember that. So think about it. Freedom. Ultimately, freedom will cost you everything. But freedom is actually the only place where you will be happy.